Voices on y'all, hallelujah. How y'all feeling? Y'all feeling good? Y'all feeling good? Y'all feeling great? Y'all looking good? Y'all looking good? And I smell some of y'all. Y'all smell like y'all took a shower, hallelujah. Yes, y'all smell good too. I love it. Welcome to Poets Paint Praise. And I added another P on that thing. Pino, where the pastor at? Where pastor at? Pino Grigio next time, pastor. I'm a part of the Grape Stomping Ministry. Yes, I am. This is the spot. This is the spot. If you don't know, the spot is the place where you should be. The spot is the place to be on this Good Friday. Come on, give God some praise. Come on, give God some praise. I don't know what time it is, but I know we running on black folk time. But y'all keep, you know, y'all just go work with us. Hallelujah. That's what we gonna do. So I am Naisha, and my pastor entrusted me to be the MC for tonight.
Uh-oh.
I don't know why. The people who know me sitting in the back, because they know I'm a little crazy. So before we get started with anything, if you, ladies, men, gentlemen, the bathrooms are in the back, down this hall. To the right, there's a family bathroom. To the very back is the ladies' bathroom. So, and the men's bathroom is back there. If you have any children, and there's a place for them to color and paint and be a part of the service also. This is Destiny Presents the Seven Last Sayings with Poets Paint and Praise. Come on, give God some praise this morning. This morning. But tonight, I need to get my life together. Guys, the very first person that is coming up for tonight's poetry night is Miss Adrienne Keeler. She is going to speak on Luke 23:34. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And Luke 23:43. Truly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. So put your hands together for Miss Adrienne Keeler. Keep your hands together. Keep your hands together. Hey.
Hello? All right, there we go. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
All right, so as she mentioned, those are the two Bible verses that my poem is based off of. And my poem is called Forgiveness. Every day we go through our lives fighting to survive. Blinded by our lies, that we can do this on our own, that we're fully grown, that we're already on the throne. His spirit is inside of us, so a piece of our soul is unused, yet somehow we're confused. Turn to a worldly muse. Trying to lean on something new, slowly fading to a negative hue. We are ignorant of our wrongdoings. Jesus said we know not what we do, as he hung on the cross with all our sins he bared. Taking time to ask for forgiveness on behalf of you and me. Although we've fallen short, he still invites us to paradise, looking past all our faults, seeing our heart, pouring into our soul. He sees the beauty beyond the ignorance.
I go down into your deep down.
DJ. I was just getting into it. I'm about to, yes. Come on, y'all. Come on. Give it up for Miss Adrian Keeler. But y'all got to do this. Y'all got to do this. Yes. Yes. Y'all so woke. Y'all real woke. That's what I'm talking about. Poetry. Clicking. All right. Next up, we have, oh, wow. This is what I'm excited for. Yes. Along, we have Miss Kristen Martin with John 19:26-27. Woman, behold your son. Son, behold your mother. And Matthew 27:46 and Mark 15:34. My God, why have you forsaken me? Come on, give it up for Miss Kristen Martin.
Called Forsaken. My God, my God, why have you forsaken me? Carrying this cross was heavy, but the burden of all this sin is heavier, and my soul is in anguish under the pressure, and I know it was destined, but I never could have expected just how agonizing this pain would be. My God, can you hear me? It's your most beloved son. Are you listening? And I know you've always been there, but I just can't find another way to express this pain that I bear. So let me close my eyes for just a second and remember who I am. Let me ignore these nails in my feet and these nails in my hand. Let me forget these thorns in my head and focus on your plan as to why you had to forsake me. My eyes are closed for just a second. I see them, Father. I can't forget them. I see them brokenhearted. I see them burdened. I see them tempted. I see them hurting, and I hang here for them because they're worth it, because they're my world, because they're my heart, and this weight I carry alone for them is too hard. I close my eyes for just a second. I know exactly who I am. I am the redeemer of the world. I am the cornerstone of your plan. I was beaten and bruised to bring them life abundantly and make them new that they may never have to feel this agony too. Yes. My heart, my world, why have you forsaken me? Forsaken each other, forsaken love. Behold your mother, woman, behold your son. Embrace each other in love as I have loved. Understand why I bore this cross. Understand the price you cost, for he has forsaken me for the sake of you, but you may never have to feel this agony too, because carrying this cross was heavy, but the burden of all my sin is heavier, so I hang here for you as the Father destined. So close your eyes for just a second and remember who I am. I am the lover of your soul. I am your redemption plan. Thank you.
Y'all got it. Hey. God's plan. Y'all in on God's plan. Now, while we're up here, while every poet is up here, we have a live pain going on. Y'all see what's going on over here? And he's doing a very good job. And if you like his art, there is one that we're going to give away, one of his paintings that we're going to give away. So y'all have to be paying attention to what y'all listening to up here, because I'm going to give y'all a quiz. And if you win, then you win the painting, okay? But it's by my rules. Why you did that, though? Because you know it's me. You know it's me. It's going to be something. It's going to be something. Right now, up next, we have a psalmist who is going to come here to bless our ears. So I need y'all to put y'all hands together. Put y'all hands together. Y'all, I ain't even say that name yet. Put your hands together for Miss Brittany Mickens.
Bad things. There's a lot of bad things. Good evening.
Good evening.
Okay. I'll be singing Above All.
I've never heard Britney sing. That's what I'm talking about. Oh my God, that was absolutely beautiful. And we have one painting already done. Clap it up for the artist up here. He doing it. He doing both of them at the same time. So, okay, I messed up. It's all right. I'm going to do it. Missy Elliott, I'm going to back that thing. I'm going to rewind. No, that was juvenile. Back that thing. Y'all know what I was listening to on my way here. It wasn't anything. Just pray for me. Stretch your hands towards. Just stretch your hands. Glory, just, I need it. I do. Pray for me. And I also have some more housekeeping. You reminded me, Pastor, in the office, he told me on Sunday for Easter, don't be coming up in here with no lime green on. Last time, it triggered his Tourette's. I'm just saying, y'all don't be coming up in here with them loud colors. My pastor have some vision issues. Yeah, we having a white party. Don't come up in here with the lime green. Okay. No, the splash of color is blue, okay? If you're going to wear anything other than white, wear some blue, all right? Some of y'all need to wear a whole bunch of blue because y'all still sinning. I'm going to wear all from head to toe. From head to toe, I'm going to be in blue. It's not going to be white for me. How about that? The more blue you wear, the more sin that you need to be prayed upon about, okay? All of us going to be right in front here. I'm going to be there by myself. Y'all not laughing. Cause y'all know y'all going to be up here with me. Look at them. Talking about I got Saturday. I got a few more hours before this Easter party come up and I got to repent. Yes, God. Okay. Let me move on, Lord, because I could be up here talking about my pastor real bad. The next voice that you're going to hear right now is another poet, and his name is Orville, the poet, and he is coming from John 19:28, I thirst, and John 19:30, it is finished. So put your hands together for Orville, the poet.
She say, do you love me? I tell her only.
That was y'all jam. Y'all, everybody's like, man, wait a minute. I know you're going to do a poem, but let that play out a little bit. Let that play out, because that is a cool song. That is actually a cool song. All right, so my name's Over the Poet. Let me do something real quick. Make some noise for yourselves. However you feel about you, make that much noise. Yeah! Now, however you feel about what God's brought you through, make that much noise. Yeah! They said I was coming to destiny, so I just wanted to get an energy check real quick. All right, so the first verse, 19:28. Thirst. Now, when I sat and thought about that, what do I thirst for? And then better yet, what quenches my thirst? A lot of times, things that quench my thirst aren't things good for me. I got this piece. Is that okay for me to share?
Absolutely.
Cool.
Can I not use this and everybody hear me?
Yes.
When you're recording, do you want me to use the mic? She said, yeah, I'm a bait Tasha. Tasha, I don't want no smoke with Tasha.
I just met her and I don't want no smoke. All right, here we go. I'm trying hard to be something different. I'm trying hard to be something new. But see, it's hard to be good when good and bad are inside of you. I tried to change on my own, but see, I lacked all the ingredients. But I just knew I could do it by myself due to my conceitedness. And this road I'm traveling now is a hard one due to its steepness. But see, on this road, a lot of things will be lost. And God also whispered in my ear and told me these things cost. But God also whispered and told me he paid the cost to be the boss way before Rick Ross. And that he could read my mind without the help of any psychics. And he just wanted to be by my side for communication. No text message needed, just sidekick. The Holy Spirit kept saying, he's all you need, just try. But nah, not today was always my reply. See, I fought hard and dirty not to give up my rights. Ortiz and Mayweather worthy, but not four rounds my whole life. I was thirsting for something I could touch. Get so frustrated at times I would scream. But God revealed himself that he's always by my side and I could feel him like my touch screen. I finally learned how to dream and see I'm a man now, so it's time for me to put away childish things. I'm so glad that God writes our sins in sand and the commandments in stone. I would read the Bible before and it seems as if it was written in code. But see, I have understanding now because I've been lit a fire like a barbecue coal and now I'm spitting sick truth. And I don't have no cold. See, I used to sit in church and leave the offering plate empty. This may come as a surprise to some saints, but temptations still tempt me. But see, the difference is now I know if I fall, I can always call on God because he's my safety.
Yeah.
See, a lot of y'all might hear this poem right now and think of my spiritual walk, I'm an adult. When the truth is, I'm an adolescent. I still have peace for us. I just wish you could see the nights I dropped to my knees and prayed for my faith to be as long as my hair was. For the Bible to be my GPS and his will my coordinates. To finally stop being so stubborn and insubordinate. We were called for greatness. That's our fate. And as a people, we see success quicker if we just ate what he prepared on our plates. An ordinary life is when he called us to follow, or for that matter, lead. And our lives every day are movies that show this to we. So do yourself and others around you a favor and never miss the show. Greatness is playing every single day, and it's guest starring you. That's that piece. So real quick, who knows where snapping came from? Opportunity to teach. Nobody knows? Nobody know? Cool. So snapping came from back in slavery times, where we used to gather in secret compartments under floorboards or what have you. Whoever was carrying out the discussion or the meeting, if you understood and agreed with what was being said as to not draw attention to yourself or your location, you snapped. So I always encourage both because we can do both. And what you do when you snap and clap, you're paying homage to those that can only snap. All right? So share that though. Share that in your weekend. Be like, you know where this came from, cuz? Yeah. Snaps. So now it is finished. When I read text, I internalize it. Because if I don't, I'm not going to understand it. It's not going to mean nothing to me. It's just going to wash over. You know what I mean? Like a book, you got to just read to pass this test real quick. Yeah, you read it and you comprehend it, but it don't really stay with you. Right, so I try to, when I hear verses and read things, I try to internalize, like, what does that mean to me, Orville? So when I seen the "it is finished" text, what's finished? The work is finished? Is my work finished? What am I here to do? So this poem, this next poem is entitled Passion. And what is finished for me is doubting and playing around with the gift God gave me. That's finished. That's done. We're done with that. There's no more doubting. Should you be? This is the gift I gave you. Go use it. So everyone in the sound of my voice has been given a gift. And you might not know it, but your gift is the thing you do best with the least amount of effort. Your gift is the thing you do best with the least amount of effort. Now your gift, once you find it, it's a crash course into your purpose, right? And once you start working in your purpose, there's another symptom called passion. Passion is the ability to wake up early in the morning, stay up late at night, do something all day free, simply because you're passionate about it. So when I saw that verse in text, that's what resonated with me. So this poem is entitled Passion. If you feel anything I'm saying, feel free to snap, clap, yell out cool stuff like, yes. You know what I mean? You're not going to mess me up, I promise, all right? I like a lot of energy. Like, don't just be sitting there looking at me like, all right, we good? We cool? Take your cool off, put it on the ground. We here chilling. I done had turkey sandwiches in the back. I'm here, all right? Here we go. What do you do when your passion doesn't pay your bills? Some adults might feel me. This is a real one right here. And what do you do? Are you about to give me an answer, cuz? No, I'm not. But just listen. What do you do when your passion doesn't pay your bills? I mean, what container does your passion really fill? See, I feel fulfilled whenever I step up and pour out my heart and soul on the mic, but some audience members still leave empty like, I never spilled anything. So I'm steady thrashing through obstacles, trying to overcome my own doubt, because the Lord told me my passion is the one thing I should never try to live life without. He gave it to me to use, not refuse, so I keep that in mind when I hear those one-sided reviews like, it's the dude with the locks again. Oh girl, I bet he don't got no romantic pieces. He think he better than us because he be talking about Jesus. See, no, I just talk, but if you choose to listen, that means I've already been aligned into my correct position. I don't welcome opposition, but I will stand with the truth and see my passion is the general and them alphabets, they my troops. And when we get in formation, words are formed. Through my passion, I am reborn and show what my true purpose is. See, if I just rhyme a lot and I don't have a message, that's worthless to me. If I don't inspire you and leave you with something to dwell on, I'm not taking my part in heightening your senses. And no super elaborate rhyme scheme here. The poem is for y'all. I desperately want you to get it. Because somewhere along the line, I think artists stop spitting pieces with messages. And merely spitting pieces for themselves. Taking part in the game, but there's nothing to gain, so why are we playing? Grabbing hold of the proverbial arrow and releasing it at high velocity at the target. And in this world, everyone has something to sell. And in this world, everyone has something to sell. And there will always be a market. See, some people are selling fish, while others are selling chicken. I'm giving the truth, but there's no one left to listen. And it seems like the very same people we try to uplift are the very same ones trying to bury our God-given gifts. Taking our syllables and dragging them through the mud. We see those hate-filled stares, but like Dr. King said, we must combat them with love. And it used to be a cliche to me that it costs nothing for you to pay attention to me. But it's crazy to see what poets, pastors, and motivational speakers do with adjectives, nouns, and verbs. Someone asked me the other day if my passion was. I pray it's obvious. It's spoken word. Thank you guys so much. Appreciate it. Clap it up for your MC and your host, though.
Oh, yeah.
I was laughing. She was having me rolling back here. I almost spit on my water. The MC jump. Yeah.
Clean that bill. Clean the bill to clean up the carpet. Give it up one more time for Orville the Boy. All I'm saying is, I didn't see no ring on his finger, and they got single ladies in the house. I'm just gonna walk up on that. I'm just saying, he said he was aligned. Yes, God. Ain't that what we looking for, single ladies? That's what y'all looking for. I ain't single, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me. Y'all know I'm just playing. I love my man. I knew that when we had poets up in here, it was gonna get real deep. It was gonna get real deep. Snap. I had no idea where that came from. That's what I'm talking about. He taught me something new. Look at God. So I'm excited because this next poet coming up is someone who's very close to me. Someone who I did not even know had this ability. Someone who preaches to me every Sunday. And I'm so excited to hear what he has to say. I was waiting for y'all to start snapping for me. Golly. I am not Orville, and no, I am not Christine or Adrian or none of them, but I just gave y'all poetry from my heart. I just wrote that thing sitting right there. I'm looking at my purpose. Giving God. God just gave me a new gift. My pastor Kev is the Rev. It's gonna be real heavy. He gonna Millie Rock on the stage. And he look good for his age. Bless the Lord for AARP. Y'all, Pastor Kevin is coming up next. And he will be speaking on Luke 23:46. Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. Give it up for our pastor, Pastor Kevin J.
Now everybody's wondering, could this really be it? Is Pastor Kev about to poetically spit? Can he really drop thought-provoking verses that reach? Absolutely not the last word I'm going to preach. Can we give it up for everybody who's been on the stage tonight? Have you not? You got to learn how to stay in your lane. You know what I mean? I can't do what they do. That was amazing. I have enjoyed every song. I mean, this has just been incredible. I love my church. I love my church because my church wants to do something different to reach this city. We have a heart for the city to reach this city. And so we decided to do the seven last sayings in a very different way. And I'm just so excited to be a part of this. Let me tell you this. This is just the beginning. You need to come back Sunday for our white party. It's going to be amazing. Y'all realize something. See, everything we do is intentional. So in between every poet, we've been playing Drake's God's Plan. And so this entire night, we've been talking about the crucifixion of our Savior, which was God's redemptive plan for you and me. And so we don't do stuff haphazardly. There really is a method behind the madness. And so I'm excited to be able to give the last word on tonight. I'm not going to hold you long. Can we pray? And then I'll preach the last word. Father, we thank you so much for every poet, every psalmist. God, we thank you for everything you've done for us tonight. God, we pray that you will continue to speak to our heart. And God, we pray that you will inevitably draw us closer to you. Now, God, do for me what I can never do for myself, and that is to allow people to sit, listen to me, and hear you. It's in Jesus' name I pray. We all say,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Okay. So, at first, I was slightly confused, if I'm being honest, as I'm reading the last seven last sayings, because the sixth word is, it's finished. But if it's finished, then why do we have a seventh word?
Yeah.
And so this is what Jesus says. Jesus says, the sixth word says, it's finished, but I never said that I'm finished.
Hey, right.
Don't miss that. Don't miss that. Yeah. Don't miss that. Because that's extremely important for you and for me, because just because it's finished doesn't mean we finished.
Right.
See, the relationship might be finished, but that doesn't mean you finished.
Right.
The job might be finished, but it doesn't mean you're finished. And just because it's finished doesn't mean that you're finished. And so he goes on to let us know with the seventh word. He says, Jesus called out in a loud voice, Father, into your hands I commit my spirit. And when he had said this, he breathed his last. I want to share with you something that's obvious, and then I want to share something that's not so obvious. He says,
He says, Father. Now, this is a term that Jesus has used in private amongst his disciples. This is a word he's used in the company of his closest, because up until this point, but now publicly he's saying that the relationship with God has changed. Up until that point, the people thought that it was angry, distant God who only punished you for wrongdoing. And Jesus says, the relationship has now changed. You need to call him Daddy. Somebody who loves you, somebody who's going to be intimate, somebody who cares about you. And so the relationship has changed. He says, Father. Then he says, into your hands I commit my spirit. Into your hands I commit my spirit. Watch. He says, I'm going to place my spirit in your hands. Y'all got about 4 minutes for me to teach. God creates the spirit of man. God is the ultimate creator. Watch this slowly. He says in Genesis 1:26, 1:27, God has a huddle with himself, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And he says, we should make man in our image. Drops down to verse 27. He says, so God created male and female, God created them. So he creates man in 1:27. That was on the sixth day. On the seventh day, it said God chilled. God took a break. God rested on the seventh day. Around chapter 2, verse 7, it now says God reaches in the dirt and forms the body of man. Well, wait a minute. Did he create man in 1:27 or did he create man in 2:7? I'm glad I piqued your curiosity. Here's the thing. He creates the spirit of man in 1:27, but he forms the body of man in 2:7. He blows what he created into what he formed, and man becomes a living soul. Don't miss that. He says this to Jeremiah, just further proof. He says, before I formed ye in the belly, I knew you. Yeah. How could you know me? Because I knew your spirit. And once I know your spirit, I blow what I created into what I form, and you'll become. Watch this. Jesus says, take what you created and hold it for me. Don't miss this. God don't have a problem holding what he created. The problem is we try to give God what we've mustered up, not what he's created. And you say, God, well, why didn't the marriage work? He said, I didn't create that. That was something you dreamed up. And you say, God, well, why didn't that relationship work? He said, because I didn't create it. That was something that you. All right. God has no problem holding what he created. But watch this. So that was what was obvious. Let me show you what's not obvious. You only give somebody you trust the ability to hold what's precious to you. You will only give somebody you trust the ability to hold something for you. Watch this. And you only give them your treasure to hold if you're coming back to get it.
All right.
Let me help. I got about 3 more minutes before I need to take a seat. I'm from Maryland. In Prince George's County, born and raised on the playground. That's where I spent most of my day. Chilling and maxing, relaxing and cooling and shooting some b-ball outside the school. Well, a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in. Well, 2, 3. 9. Okay, that's probably where our stories diverge. See, I grew up in a very different era where the first thing wasn't to reach for a gun, that you could settle something with a fisticuff and then become friends after that. The Fresh Prince, when his mama heard that he got into a fight, she said, you're moving with your auntie and auntie in Bel Air. I didn't have that person. My kids grow up with a beautiful impatient woman by the name of Mimi. I did not know her growing up. I tell kids, I'll sit around and tell stories about my mama sometime, and my kids will say, "That don't sound like Mimi to you," and I said, "It wasn't, it was mama." I'm telling you a story about mama. I said, "I didn't meet Mimi until you met Mimi." Grew up with somebody else. Totally different. So, just for instance, so one time I come home and I said, "Mom," I said, "there's some guys at school," and I think I was in about fourth grade, and I said, "They're going to jump me." Now, today, a parent would go up to school to have a meeting with the principal, and she wanted to bring the deputy, but the deputy's already there now. It's a whole different type of school system. But my mama said to me, she said, my mama's sitting in the back too. My mama said, this is what she said to me. She said, "What you need to do is take a pipe and bust him in the head." And I said, "Word? Word, that's what I should do?" Now, in the fourth grade, it sounded like a great suggestion to me. And for me, it confirmed what I had already suspected. I had been suspecting for a long time. My mama was a genius. So, the next day, I get up and I find the pipe. Now, you would think I would pick a pipe that would fit in my backpack. No, no, no. Because it was a Cooper. I picked something that had been buried in concrete in the ground. I could barely drag it in. So I walked into school dragging a pipe with concrete on the back. I'm scratching up the school floor and sparks shooting out the bottom of the pipe. And the principal says, "Kid, where you going with the pipe?" And I told him, I said, "Yesterday, I was going to get jumped, and my mama said, you should probably bust him upside the head with the pipe, and here is the pipe, because I'm about to take care of it." He says, "I'm going to need you to come into the office." And he sits me down, put my pipe in the corner, and he says, "Miss Jones," he says, "I have Kevin in the office here, and look, he says," kids are so silly, "he says you told him to bring this pipe to school to hit these kids in the head with this pipe, and I know." What did you say? Oh, really? Okay. We're just going to send him back to class then. He says, "Kevin, you can go back to class." I said, can I take my pipe? Can I take my pipe? Because guess what? I never got jumped. And so the moral of the story is, no, there's no more. All I'm trying to say is, I grew up in an era where you had to fight.
Yeah.
So, there were times when you knew the scuffle was coming, because somebody would say something like this: "Hey, after school, I'm going to meet you on the side, and it's just me and you." Right? So, after school, you would show up. And so you would say to your closest friend, you would say, "Hey, hold my stuff."
That's right. Hold my stuff. That's true.
"And when I'm done, I'm coming back for my..." Y'all missed it? Okay. Jesus says to his father, "Hold my stuff, because I'm about to fight. And when I'm done, I'm coming back for my..." Okay, watch this. Jesus let everybody know what was about to go down, but they never did pick up on it. Let me tell you why. Watch this. Jesus says, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." What Jesus is doing is he's quoting Psalm 31:5. Verbatim, he quotes Psalm 31:5. Well, Pastor Kev,
What significance does Psalm 31:5 have to do with this? I'm glad you asked. That's why I love preaching smart people, because they ask great questions. Let's read Psalm 31 from 1 to 5, and then I'll show you the significance, all right? He says, this is the Psalm of David. He says, starting at verse 1, he says, "In you, O Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Turn your ear to me. Come quickly to my rescue. Be my rock of refuge, a strong fortress to save me. And since you are my rock and my fortress, for the sake of your name, lead and guide me. Keep me free from the trap that is set before me. For you are my refuge." Watch this. "Into your hands I commend my spirit." Now, here's what's really significant about this. Jewish women used Psalm 31, 1 through 5, as a bedtime prayer for their children. Psalm 31, 1 through 5 is our equivalent of, "Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I pray the Lord my soul." And see, Psalm 31, 1 through 5 was a bedtime prayer, and none of the Jewish people in the audience picked up on it. That here Jesus is on the cross, has sin is finished, and now he's saying his prayers, "Now I lay me down to sleep." Y'all still don't get it. Okay. I got 2 more minutes to make a plan. Jesus let everybody know that even though what looks like death, I'm laying down just to go to sleep. Because sleeping people come back. Y'all, okay. Watch this. He let everybody know. My grandma used to say it this way. That every goodbye ain't gone, and every sleeping eye ain't sleep. Huh? Every closed eye ain't sleep. Jesus let you know. That what happens is, I know y'all crying. I know y'all upset. I know y'all, your hearts are pouring out. But if you just take the hint, it'll let you know that I'm just about to go to sleep. And he slept Friday night. He slept all day Saturday. And the old preacher said, "Early Sunday morning." Come on, somebody. He woke up. Okay, watch this. Y'all remember. Jesus has just healed a lady with an issue of blood. Watch this. And he's traveling with his little church, and Jairus comes and he approaches Jesus, and he says, "Jesus, my daughter is sick and dying." And Jesus, he says, "My daughter's dead." And Jesus says, "Your daughter is asleep, and I'm about to awaken the damsel." Yeah. Watch this. Throughout the New Testament, they equate sleep with. Here's another one. Y'all remember. Jesus and his little church is hanging out in Bethsaida, and a messenger comes running in the door and says, "Jesus, the one whom you love is sick." Yeah. Talking about Lazarus. And he tells his disciples, he says, "Y'all sit down. We ain't going nowhere." And then after about 4 days, he says, "Let's go, because Lazarus is dead. Watch this. And I'm going to wake him." Jesus says his bedtime prayers because he wants us to know that if we're in relationship with him, that death isn't the finality, that death is only a nap until he awakens us. Let me give you a bite. 1 Thessalonians 4:16 says, "For the Lord himself shall come from heaven with a loud command and the voice of an archangel and the trump call of God, and the dead in Christ, the sleeping ones, will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together in the cloud to be with the Lord." And forever, come on, Come on, somebody. See, death for the believer isn't a finality. It's just a sleep.
Amen.
So he says, Father, into your hands I commit my spirit. And for those Jewish mothers in the audience that were paying attention, he let them know that even though I got to leave, I'm coming back. God bless you.
Come on, DJ, turn that up. What? Come on, DJ, turn that up. Y'all put your hands together for one of the greatest pastors in the state of Virginia, in the state of Maryland, and D.C., the old DMV, my pastor. We get that every Sunday. We get that every Sunday. He'll be along with it sometimes, but like tonight, he was like 2 minutes, and it had been 10 whole minutes past. And he was like, I got 2 more minutes. I was like, no, you passed that up a long time ago, Pastor. He got excited, but we get that every single Sunday. We get the word straight from the Bible. And he gives it to us in such a way that you know it's God. That you know that he's listening to God. I don't want to get too deep on y'all tonight. But I'm just saying, he is a great pastor. He is keeping us connected. He is keeping us connected to God in what, Destiny? Worship. Connected to each other in what? Oh, y'all listening. And connected to the community in what? We do it up here at Destiny Church. I'm serious. Our pastor is passionate. Our ministers are passionate. Our first lady is passionate. And everyone in all these committees are passionate about Christ, about getting people here, about hearing a solid word, hearing words that are convicting. We get meat and potatoes here. We get meat and potatoes here because our pastor, he is obedient to God. And when you're obedient to God, sometimes your messages aren't the messages that people want to hear, but it's the messages that people need. And so I'm so thankful for you, Pastor, although you're trying to take my job a little bit with your little comedy bit, but we're going to talk about that later. Because I know where you live at. I know where he lives, right across the street. That's how close I am to God. Look how I gotta live across the street from my pastor to keep me in line. But I'm all in line. Y'all not gonna play with me tonight. I love it. Let's keep this going. Are y'all enjoying yourselves? I really am enjoying myself too. Everything that I've heard. In the way that all the poets have put God's word into the words that, man, y'all better go ahead on with y'all bad selves. The next, we are going to have a praise dance. A praise dance. She told me I couldn't be on her praise dance team, and I felt a little something, so maybe I'll mess up her name. No, I'm going to give it to her, Miss Nikki Montgomery. Put your hands together.
Thank you.
I surely know that I'm not worthy. But he did it anyway. And I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. I'm grateful to know that he loved me enough. He loved me enough to know what I was gonna do. He loved me enough to know my mind and what I was going to do. He died for my future sins too, not just for my past. He died for what he knows I'm going to do later on, and what I'm going to do on Saturday, and what I'm going to do on Sunday, and what I'm going to do on Monday. He died for that purpose. And you should be so thankful. So thankful knowing there is none. There is none like him. None like him. A holy and risen Savior. That's what we celebrate. He rose again. He did. Oh my God is so good and he is so great. We here at Destiny Church, we don't just do this for being seen. We do this because we know who God is, and we want to get that message out to everyone. We want everyone to know who he is and why he was and why he rose. Tonight has been a beautiful night with these artists. We still have the painter back here, Meech. Give it up for Meech back here. But everything that we do, we can't do it without finances.
Amen, amen, amen.
We cannot do it without finances. And if you feel like you've been blessed tonight, if you feel like you just want to give something, please, this is the opportunity right now to give to our ministry so that we can grow, so that we can continue to serve and reach those people out here who need to know and hear the word. They need to know who Jesus is. This is my husband.
Amen.
And I'm talking about
him. How many of y'all have ever come to a service like this? Wasn't this absolutely amazing? This shows just how creative God's people really, really is. God has some creative, God is a creative God, right? But Jesus is creative, right? Right. And so he has creative people. And this is an opportunity for us. I'm so happy to be serving alongside and a man that I'm telling you is worth following. Our pastor to just open up this place and just want to do things in such a creative way. Let God be shown in this place. See, God was shown here. His creative was shown here. He created each and every one of us in a unique way and then gave us gifts. Yeah. Gave us gifts so we could take those gifts and show it to the world. And that was done here today. Amen, amen. I don't know why I wasn't in the lineup.
Cut off his mic. Cut his mic because he's
trying to see.
The sound ministry is so on point tonight.
The sound ministry back there. Y'all just wait. I don't know why I was sliding.
I should be up here singing. I have a voice. And I need my voice to be heard in many ways. Yeah. Not just all.
Y'all know that still voice, that still quiet voice, that's the voice he need to sing in. Because he don't know what, he don't know a key. There's no key, he don't sing in no keys.
I know all the keys. All of them. Every single one of them.
Ain't no holiness in his singing. But while God is in the blessing, maybe he can get, because our pastor started comedy tonight. I'm just saying, he started poetry tonight. While he's in a blessing, he might bless you with a new one. Try it, boo. Try it. Try it. Try it.
I already feel it.
Let me hear it.
Okay.
No.
I wasn't in the lineup, so I'm not gonna give y'all everything I have.
No, it wasn't.
I still feel slighted.
I didn't feel no anointing.
Alright, you feel it? That's Chrissy. Y'all don't know Chrissy.
Jesus done left the building.
Chrissy is always on my side. Amen, amen. Let us all.
Let's pray, guys.
Let's all pray for this offering. Bow our heads. Father, we thank you so much for this time, God. Thank you so much for everything that you consistently do in our lives, Father. Father, thank you for
this time that you have ordained, God. Father, thank you for the people and their creativeness, God. Thank you for being a creative God. Thank you for the gifts that you have given each and every one of us, God. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to show that gift, God. And Father, we have destiny, God. We're so thankful for the mission that you've given us, God. And Father, we serve you with every single thing that we have. We're so happy, Father, just for who you are. We're so happy for what you've given us, God. We're so happy, Lord God, for everything that we have. We're so happy, Lord God, that we know that you've paid that price for us, God. So, Father, we just thank you for life. We thank you for everyone that just came here, Lord God, to hear from you. And you've spoken, God, and we've heard you loud and clear through every single person. Praise God. Poets, painting, the dance. God, we've heard you. And so, Father, right now we pray for this offering. We pray that it continues to build up this place we call destiny, God. As we continue to serve you in every single way that you would have us serve. We thank you and we love you. It's in your Son Jesus Christ's holy name. Let us all say, amen. Amen.
We also can use the Bible app. There's an app for giving also for y'all young folks. Givelify. You can download the app on your phone, find our church, Destiny Church VA, and you can give that way also. Also, you can follow us at The Spot. This is The Spot. Follow us on Facebook. I believe we have The Spot Coffee House on Instagram, on Facebook. And we got the Twitter, like my grandma said, the Twitter. I don't know if we have the Twitter, but we're going to get the Twitter soon, okay? But follow us on at The Spot Coffee House for more happiness, more going on. So y'all can, we going to have more poetry nights. I like this. I like this. Did y'all enjoy the poets? Did y'all enjoy the psalmist? She sang effortlessly. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Did y'all enjoy the praise dance?
Yes.
She brought in, she ushered in that spirit. Yes, I loved it. I loved it. And our artist up here, Meech, still doing his thing. Big Meech has a painting to give away. I said this time would come. I'm looking around because I might just give it away to somebody who was nice enough to clap for me. She started clapping hard, yes! I'm going to take you everywhere I go. So this is The Spot, right? And this is where we worship at, right? Do anybody, the first person to raise their hand, we having a white party on Sunday for Easter, right? For, really? Y'all was listening, right? We having a white party. Mm-hmm. With a splash of color. What's the color? She was the first to raise her hand. And she will fight. I know her. She has to come to church every Sunday because she fights. I know it. I know her. Stretch your hands towards her. The young lady right here, because she be fighting. She be at her job fighting and stuff. She is not yet. God is doing a mighty work over there. Our pastor, we pray for him a lot because of her. Yes. Did you talk about me? You said me? For me? I'm good, Pastor. I was good tonight, right? I didn't do nothing bad yet. Look at you. Yeah. You feel it? I'm going to hook you up with a painting. I became an artist tonight, too. I got you. You gonna get my comedy CD, my poetry book. I'm about to come out with an album, and I got some art. Find me in the parking lot right afterwards. So this is going out. She won it. She won it. I wasn't even gonna say her name because we taping, and I don't want people out there to know that Ashley, the fighter, was here. See, I was trying to help her out. Oh, okay. Yeah, we want the people who fight. We do. We got fight for Jesus. Hey! We got all kinds of ministries here. Because I've been whipping and naming him for Jesus all Sunday. I've been killing it. I'm telling you, I do. I've been killing it. Yeah. The twerk team. Pastor Ann said that we couldn't do it no more. He said we couldn't do it no more. I was like, but we got the men here, and they need to be saved too. That's all right. I'm sorry on behalf of me and my family. My husband didn't know that I was bringing the team here, and he didn't know about the uniforms. It's all right. We go get them next time, girl. So if you enjoyed yourself, come on, give God some praise. God, some praise up here. You coming? I think Meech got something to say. Come on, Meech.
How y'all doing, first of all? I just want to say, it feels good to be around a bunch of beautiful people. Brown, yellow, white, don't matter. It's a very, very beautiful event. I want to thank y'all for letting me be a part of it. I want to also, real quick, let me get a round of applause for everybody that was here. Everyone, the artists, all the poets, all the speaker notes. I got two special pieces. I was only going to give one to the church, but I think I'm going to give both of them to you. I had a really, really good time with y'all. I enjoyed myself, so it's only right. And I thank y'all for having me. Thank y'all.
I done became a cameraman, too. Look at God. He is bestowing all the gifts. Yes, God, even me. Yes. These are beautiful. Thank you so much. Thank you guys for coming to say hi to the camera. This means people. Yes, y'all look so lovely. Now it's time to go. All right, get up out of here. Bye-bye. Thank y'all for coming. Thank you for, I hope that you enjoyed yourselves. Anything else, Pastor? Come to the white party on Sunday. If y'all think we did up tonight, on Sunday, on Easter, we gonna wear our Easter best white with a splash of look at God. Yes, she gonna be wearing red. Hallelujah. Thank you guys and good night. Thank you.